It kept us waiting a little longer than in previous years, but in March Samsung finally rewarded our patience with the Galaxy S8 and Galaxy S8 Plus. These smartphones then went on sale in April as the best phones of 2017 to date. Now the Galaxy S7 was already a pretty decent phone. In fact, Samsung has won the crown in our best smartphones chart for the past 3 years running. Is it too much to ask for the company to improve on an already good thing? Well, yes and no. Because the Galaxy S8 is a fantastic flagship, but it's not flawless. It's also facing stiff competition from more recent flagships. UK price and availability. The Galaxy S8 isn't as expensive as some feared, costing £689, with the Plus model costing an extra £90. That's still pretty pricey, though, and a fair chunk more than the Galaxy S7, which launched at £569. But it's so much less than the £999 iPhone X. You can order the S8 directly from Samsung or Carphone Warehouse. You can also order it on contract from as little as £37.99 per month from me, Vodafone and O2, through Carphone Warehouse, or from 3. He also exclusively stocks an Arctic Silver version. We've also put together a full guide on where to buy the Galaxy S8. It's good to see more in the box than most phones, including two USB-C adapters, one to full-size USB and the other to micro USB, and a pair of AKG headphones with extra tips. The Galaxy S8 is available in Midnight Black, Orchid Gray, Coral Blue, and Arctic Silver, with a new Rose Pink model announced in January 2018. There's also a burgundy red option that's currently available only in Korea, but is rolling out to other markets soon. Design and build. If the Galaxy S7 was stunning in design, then we're not exactly sure how to describe the Galaxy S8 apart from that it's on another level. It makes its predecessor, and other phones, look dated. Samsung has brought its edge screen technology to both phones this year, so you don't need to buy the larger Galaxy S8 Plus to get the full experience. This not only looks great but has a big advantage when it comes to keeping the size of the phone from getting out of control. The S8 is pretty much the same width, thickness and weight compared to its predecessor. It's just a few millimeters taller but jumps from 5.1 to 5.8 and when it comes to screen size. So what would typically be an unwieldy device feels barely any different in the hand. It's a really impressive piece of craftsmanship, largely down to significantly reducing the bezels at the top and bottom. A screen-to-body ratio of over 83% is impressive stuff. The physical home button and accompanying capacitive keys are gone to achieve this. Now you have on-screen navigation and a pressure-sensitive home button built into the display. We'll talk about this more later. The fingerprint scanner is now on the back, but awkwardly placed next to the camera rather than below it. Right-handed users are likely to smudge the camera when using it. This is our main bugbear in terms of the design, and it should really be below the camera, despite creating an unsymmetrical look. Many users will be pleased to hear that Samsung has retained the headphone jack on the bottom. The Galaxy S8 is made from a lot of glass once again, so it's a little slippery, but has a Gorilla Glass 5 pack to resist damage. You'll probably want to get a case to protect this expensive slab of metal and glass, though, which is a shame considering the outstanding design. Check out the best Galaxy S8 cases. As you'd expect, the Galaxy S8 is fully dust and waterproof like its predecessor, so has an IP68 rating. That extra button you see on the left side of the phone is to quickly launch Bixby, Samsung's artificial intelligence assistant. See the software section for more on this. There are 5 colors to choose from, but in the UK we got just 3 at launch: Midnight Black, Orchid Grey and Arctic Silver, the latter an exclusive. Samsung may well bring the blue and gold options at the later date, but we'll have to wait and see.